Are you playing the finals on a low-end PC and looking for the best optimization guide for the game? Then you are at the right place. We have got the easy ways to extract the best out of the game on a low-end PC. Welcome back to Silicophilic, your go-to source for tech tips and fixes. Method 1. Search for game mode settings in the Windows search bar and make sure the option is toggled on. Next, open Steam. Find Finals and right-click on the game. Go to Manage. Then select Browse Local Files. Select the entire directory where the game is installed. Right-click and select Copy. Exit the window. Now type GPU settings in the Windows search and select Graphics Settings. Navigate to Browse. Go to the navigation bar at the top. Remove everything inside it. Right-click on the black space and select Paste. Then press Enter. Now select discovery.exe and select Add. Next, scroll down to discovery.exe. Select Options. Select High Performance and save the changes. Next, scroll to the top to change default settings. Ensure that hardware accelerated GPU scheduling is enabled. Next, turn on the optimizations for windowed games. Method 2. Type power options in the Windows search and select the top option. From the top navigation bar, select power options. Expand the show additional plan section and select high performance. Method 3. For a better gaming experience, you should always keep your graphics drivers updated. Here is how to update the graphics drivers. Go to Device Manager. For this, right-click on the Windows search menu and select it. Expand the Display Adapter section and right-click on your graphics driver. Select the Update Driver option. For NVIDIA graphics cards, use GeForce Experience to update the graphics drivers. To download and install it, visit NVIDIA's website. Then run GeForce Experience. After the app opens, click on the Drivers tab and check for new drivers. If available, download and install it. For AMD graphics cards, follow a similar process but use the Radeon software instead. So run the app and check for any available drivers. Download and install the latest drivers. Once done, restart your PC. Method 4. You can tweak some in-game settings to get the best out of the finals. These settings should increase the FPS, lower the input delay, and make your game run smoothly. Open the game settings. Go to the Gameplay tab. For Use Enemy Team Colors, you can turn it on. It helps to differentiate between the different teams. You can turn off the Hide the Player's Names features if you want to see the player's names. Next, select a preferred region for your game. You can turn on crossplay if you want it. For crosshair, you can set the width to 1 and outline the width to 1. For the colors, we set red to 0 to get the cyan blue hue and green to 255. It helps to see the maps easily. But you can adjust them as per your preferences and convenience. Here, we have set the blue color to 255, the red outline and the blue outline to 0, as we like the black outline. Next, you can turn on the center dot and set the center dot radius to 3. This is a bit lower than the default and helps to see better what you are aiming at. You can also keep it to default if you want. Set the opacity to 100. Next, move on to the video settings. Set the window mode to full screen to get a lower input delay. For resolution, you can stretch it to 1728 by 1080 or select the native resolution. 1600 by 1080 is also a good resolution. Next, disable VSync. Turn on the NVIDIA Reflex Low Latency. This can vary from player to player depending on their specs. But this is the best choice for most of the players, as you should see a massive difference in frames with the feature turned on. You can set the resolution scaling method to TAAU and 100% resolution scale, setting the resolution scaling method to AMD FSR2 at quality. AMD FSR2 is a bit sharper and clearer, making it easier to see things. TAAU should give you a slightly better FPS, but it can be blurry. Set the field of view to 100 for graphics and disable motion blur and lens distortion. Next, set the ray tracing to static. For quality settings, set the view distance to low. This is not going to affect the distance at which players render in. It only affects the distance of objects and foliage. Next, set anti-aliasing and shaders to low. Also, set the post-processing to low. Set the texture to medium. This should make the game textures more decent. However, there is not much difference between the high, medium, or epic settings. Keep the epics low. This should make things easier to see and make things less distracting. Next, you can keep the foliage low. This is not going to make any difference in the game. Also, set the global illumination resolution to low. Next, move on to the audio tab. Set the master volume to 100. If your game is too loud, then adjust your master volume accordingly. You can set the music volume to 0 and the music can be distracting. Next, set the SFX volume to 100 and dialogue volume to 60. For output mode, set it to stereo or headphones and set the night mode to off. You can remove the subtitles from the subtitle section if you don't want them. Next, set the subtitle background opacity to 0. If you want the voice chats, enable it. Set the voice chat enabled for all. Set the mode to push to talk. Next, choose the input device that you use for your microphone as the voice chat input device. For the voice chat output device, choose whatever you are using for your headphones. Now, move on to the accessibility tab. For colors, you can set the color blind mode to default or whatever you prefer. If you want it a bit vibrant, you can go for Tritanopia. Set the subtitle to off. Disable motion blur. Next, head on to the mouse and keyboard tab. You can keep a good range of sensitivity for the finals if you are on 800 dpi and set it to anywhere between 26 to 44. And if you are on 1600 dpi, then we recommend setting it from 13 to 22. Most optical sensitivities are going to fall within this range. For the mouse zoom sensitivity multiplier, set it to 100%. You can keep the mouse focal length sensitivity turned on and turn off the mouse inward vertical look output. You can keep the key binding settings to default. Method 5. The programs running in the background can sometimes conflict with the finals and cause performance issues. So close the unnecessary services running in the background to boost your gaming experience. Open Task Manager. For this, right-click on the taskbar and select Task Manager. Go to the Processes tab, look for any unnecessary processes running. Right-click on each process and select End Task option to close it. Apps like GeForce Experience, Discord, Google Chrome, and Nvidia Shadow Play can conflict with your game. So close these apps before playing the finals, and there you have it. The best optimization guide for the finals on a low-end PC. We hope the methods have worked for you. If you find this video helpful, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel for more games, tech tips, and troubleshooting guides. Leave a comment and help others know which solution solved your problem. Thanks for watching, and we will see you in the next video.